Disclaimer: this is a role play developed as part of the course curriculum for managed TB and online course for doctors. The participants have enacted the role given to them. The case discussed does not refer to any existing patient but has been developed as part of the course curriculum. The investigations, x-rays, and lab reports used in this case scenario belongs to patients treated in NIRT. Their identity have been anonymized. Sir, good morning.
Good morning, Dr. Vignesh.
Sir, I have a case to discuss with you. Is this an appropriate time, sir?
Yeah, this is the right time. We can discuss about that case now.
Sir, we have a 20-year-old young woman, a college-going student, with presenting complaints of a swelling in the left side of her lower neck for the past 1 month and generalized tenderness for the past 2 months, sir. This swelling has not responded to a course of antibiotics and she does not have any other comorbid conditions.
Okay. Did you collect any additional details of history or do any clinical examination in this patient?
Yes, sir. A detailed history reveals that she has been having this swelling for the past 1 month, which is painless and gradually increasing in size, particularly located in the left side of her lower neck, sir. She also has complaints of low-grade intermittent fever associated with loss of appetite and loss of weight for the past 1 month, sir. She does not have any exposure to a TB patient or any previous TB treatment, sir. Her HIV status is unknown and she has no immunosuppressive conditions. Her clinical examination reveals that she has 2 to 3 enlarged lymph nodes, each 2 cm in size, firm in consistency, mobile and non-tender, which were matted, located in the lower part of her cervical region. I have also checked for other lymph nodes elsewhere in the body, which turned out to be negative. There is no hepatosplenomegaly in her abdomen and there are no local infective focus elsewhere in the oral cavity, ear or the nose.
Okay. Based on the history and clinical examination findings, what do you think could be a presumptive diagnosis? How will you proceed further?
So, she satisfies the definition for a presumptive TB of the lymph nodes. So, I would like to go with final aspiration for cytology and send the samples for gene expert to detect mycobacterium tuberculosis and its rifampicin sensitivity. I will also do a chest x-ray just in case to rule out the lung pathology and check out whether she has hilar or mediastinal lymphadenopathy.
Do you think serological test for TB has any role in the diagnosis of TB lymph node?
No, sir. If I could recall from your last lecture, you have said that the serological tests are not recommended for diagnosing case of extrapulmonary TB or pulmonary TB, sir. Even the WHO and the Government of India, as per Gazette notification in June 2012, has banned these serological tests from the market, sir.
Okay. So, serological tests are not to be used for diagnosis of TB.
Yes, sir. Sir, can I make a diagnosis of TB lymph node if either the cytology or the gene expert turned out to be positive?
Yes, based on the cytology report or the gene expert results, which turns to be positive for MTB, you can start her on TB treatment.
So, what if either of these tests are negative, sir?
If either of these tests turns out to be negative, then you have to go for diagnostic biopsy.
Okay, sir. Should I take any precautions while sending the sample for biopsy?
Yeah. So, when you send the biopsy specimens for doing a bacteriological examination for smear, culture or gene expert, you have to send in a sterile container without any additives or preservatives. If you add formalin to this, the bacteria will get killed. Whereas, if you want to send the biopsy specimen to a histopathology lab, you have to send it in a container with formalin solution. Okay, so you have to be careful about this.
Okay, sir. I will take the necessary precautions. Sir, what if all these tests turned out to be negative, sir?
So, if all these tests turns out to be negative, then you have to evaluate for alternate diagnosis.
Okay, sir. Thank you. I'll just go and get started with the investigations and the treatment, sir.
Okay. Now, hope you understood how should we approach a case of TB lymph node.
Yes, sir.
Can you summarize the discussions that we had now?
Definitely, sir. Fine needle aspiration for cytology and expert for detecting mycobacterium tuberculosis and rifampicin sensitivity or a culture for mycobacterium tuberculosis have to be ordered for diagnosis of TB lymph node. Serological tests are not recommended for the diagnosis of TB. Diagnostic biopsy specimen has to be sent for histology, gene expert, MTB and rifampicin sensitivity, smear and culture for mycobacterium tuberculosis.